Hey, Greg, I was just wondering, as a data scientist, what do you actually do?
Hey, Rando. Yeah, that's easy. I bring value to data.
Okay, cool, but what do you do?
I bring value to data. I just said that.
Okay, try this. Data science is an interdisciplinary field that uses scientific methods, processes, algorithms, and systems to extract knowledge and insights from noisy, structured, and unstructured data
And apply knowledge from data across a broad range of application domains. So, can you summarize what I just said so that I know all is well? Rando, Earth to Rando.
Sorry, Greg. You said something about data, right?
Rando, this is hopeless.
No, okay. Maybe just try a little bit slower, Greg.
Data science?
Greg, that is not what I meant.
You said go slower.
Okay, slower and differently.
All right, do you know what data is?
Yeah, I think so.
Perfect. In your own words, what is data?
It's pretty much a set of observations, right?
Okay, yeah, perfect. Let's make each of those observations people to make it easy. So let's say we had for each of these people, we got their weight in pounds and their height in centimeters.
Hey, I know that centimeters is part of the metric system, but I don't know height in centimeters. Like, is 100 centimeters tall, 150, 300?
Okay, well, a 300 centimeter person would be about 10 feet tall.
Okay, can we just use like feet and inches then? How about just inches?
Okay, sure. Well, computers can do these conversions anyway. So let's say we have 100 people, we have their weight in pounds, and we also have their height in inches.
Okay, yeah, I think I'm following.
Okay, cool. So one thing you might want to do is calculate the average of all the heights, the average of all the weights, and you could also get the standard deviation of all of the heights and all of the weights.
Okay, I know what an average is. You basically sum up the values and then divide by the number of them. But I think I've heard of this standard deviation thing, although I don't really know what it is.
Oh, yeah, it's just the square root of the average squared distance between the points and the mean.
Slow.
No, it's fine. Don't worry too much about that formal definition. The standard deviation of a set of numbers is a positive number, and the bigger that number is, that means there is more spread or variation in that set of numbers.
Okay, I got it. The bigger the standard deviation, the greater the spread.
Yeah, exactly.
Hey, that actually makes sense, yeah.
Well, yeah, but does it make dollars?
I'm sorry?
It was a joke because you said it made sense, and so I was pretending that was C-E-N-T-S, sense, make sense, make dollars. Okay, whatever. So basically, that's some very common analytics, and you would use this when you want to describe a data set numerically. You might also want to get the minimum and maximum values, maybe the range. There's a lot of common metrics to describe the data set numerically.
Right, yeah.
Now, we don't always want to show our data numerically. Sometimes we want to represent it visually or graphically. So here's a scatter plot, a particular type of graph, where we have their height on the y-axis and their weight on the x-axis, and each of those blue dots is a person.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Now, what we're going to do, take it one step further, is draw a line through this data. Maybe something like this, trying to fit it as well as we can. Here, I drew a line, which is actually a statistical model. It's called a linear regression.
Question? Why would we want to draw a line through the points?
Well, for two main reasons, actually. One is that if you were to calculate the slope of this line, that would actually tell you the mathematical relationship between the weight and the height according to this data set.
The mathematical relationship. What is that?
As you can see, as the weight increases, so does the height. It goes up like this. And so the relationship is, well, as one goes up, the other does. mathematical relationship, that just kind of means, like, by how much it's going up.
Okay, yeah, but that line that you drew, like, look at it, that doesn't even go perfectly through the points. How would we trust that line? It's not even accurate.
Yeah, that's totally true. To some extent, our model is incorrect.
Greg, are you kidding me? You're going to tell me to trust some line that's not even accurate or any of this data science stuff? Is it even true? Are you just making stuff up?
All models are wrong, but some are useful. That is a famous quote from the famous statistician, George Box.
Okay, Greg, Mr. George Box Jr., you're saying we draw a line through the points and then we can understand the mathematical relationship between the weight and the height.
Yeah, precisely. That's one reason to draw a line. But there's also one more, which is to make a predictive model.
A predictive model? So something that, well, predicts things?
Yeah, so say we found another person and we measured their weight, but we didn't happen to know their height.
Oh, you're saying that since we have the weight and we don't have the height, well, we do have a model that relates weight to height, and so we can use that model, and given their weight, we can try and predict their height. Is that right?
Yeah, that's absolutely right.
Awesome. Okay, yeah, that makes sense.
But does it make dollars?
Ugh, Greg, cut it out.
Got him.
Sure. Okay, anyways, isn't this all like a little bit boring? Like a data scientist uses weight to predict height given some line? Like, that's kind of lame, no?
Oh, admittedly, it is. These are just some of the fundamentals. Think bigger picture, like maybe Google's YouTube algorithm. How do they know when you click one video exactly which ones to show you next that you might be interested in? Or maybe Amazon's product recommendation system. When you click one product, how do they know to show you five more that you might want to buy? This is all through data science.
Okay, now we're talking.
These are just some of the many possibilities for a data scientist. Me, I was actually using lung ultrasound video data in my most recent internship.
Oh, yeah, internship, and maybe a full-time job. How do I get that?
Oh, I have the pathway for becoming a data scientist in the description of the video. Or a data analyst if you'd prefer, but I think data science is cooler.
Oh no, this is a video? But that means... No!